What we do here, it goes to even 1,000 times smaller than the size of your hair. So if you are making something smaller, 1,000 times smaller than the size of your hair, you don't want a hair on your device because that would mess up a little bit what you're trying to see. So I'm Núria. I'm a PhD researcher in one of the divisions of the Microtechnology and Nanoscience department. And I work with quantum materials. What I basically do is to try to learn more from this material and the physics that describes it. But as it's a material and you cannot be asking questions, what we do is do experiments around it. So the way to do these experiments mainly is using the clean room here. So what we do is we use the material to fabricate devices on it, and then we study how it responds to different, to the different experiments that we are planning. And we are able to do it thanks to all the tools that are here that enables us to reach this nanoscale. Just to quantify it a little bit, usually like your hair diameter, it's what we say 70 microns. 70 microns, a micron is 1,000 times smaller than a millimeter. What we do here, it goes to even 1,000 times smaller than the size of your hair. So we go to very, very, very small dimensions. So I did my bachelor in Barcelona and I discovered this quantum phenomena called superconductivity, and it fascinated me because at the end, what I was learning is that you can observe these quantum phenomena in real life. And I wanted to know more. So I decided to do my bachelor thesis on this topic. And from there, I learned what a clean room was, basically, because before that, I barely stepped in and I barely knew what you could really do inside of a clean room. This clean room is incredibly big. I think it's like 1,200 meters square. It's divided into parts because what makes a clean room special and what makes a clean room, is that you have the environment control. So you control parameters as temperature or humidity, but it also controls the number of particles that there are in the environment. So these two clean rooms, they allow a certain number of particles in the air. And this is because we don't want to contaminate these very, very small devices that we are making. So if we are making something smaller, 1,000 times smaller than the size of your hair, you don't want a hair on your device because that would mess up a little bit what you're trying to see. But the clean room doesn't stand on the normal floor. It's disconnected and it goes through its own pillars. And this is because also vibrations, and here at Chalmers we have a tram that just goes behind the clean room itself. And these vibrations could affect any process that we are doing. So that's why we have, the tools basically are not on the same floor as anything in the building. You want to avoid contamination to go in because we're doing things that are devices that are very, very small. So you don't want to bring anything from the outside to the inside. And we start with whatever we left in the shoes. So we first step is the shoe cover or shoes if you have them here. And when you go in, you have the hair cover. and as if you were, if you would have a beard, you would wear a beard cover also. And then you start to dress up yourself up to which of the two clean rooms you can go. So there's one that is dirtier than the other one. And then you just need to wear a gown and gloves. And then there's the one that, it's where we do most of the fabrication, and then it's where you have to wear this overall and then another shoes on top of them. I've been doing my PhD for 3 years at this moment. I think it's a privilege to work here in the clean room. The environment is very nice, but also when you are in that clean room, you have a lot of possibilities to try out new things when you fabricate anything. And what I like is that, as you're not working alone, first of all, you have two responsibles that take care of the tools that they all work fine. They are also the persons that are most of specialized of how far you can go with that tool. So at the end, you can have advice from technicians that allow you to try to reach this nanoscale in the best conditions possible. you are supervised by very nice researchers that have a lot of experience in the field, so they can guide you in which physics to look at. However, like, I would say that the clean room is not only dedicated to research. There's a lot of startups and a lot of research and development doing here, which creates a very nice environment. I would say that it's where everything starts, because it's where you start to try out what it's working and what it's not working. For example, now it's very, for sure, I would say that a lot of people have heard of quantum computing. We have a division here that is very dedicated to do research on it and the different components that can build up this quantum computer. So I would say, yeah, it's the first level before implementing to larger scale industry. My dad has always been curious about electronics, and I've lived in this house where basically I've been told, watch out the cable, don't step on it, since I was a kid. We were building like teleferic is called in English? Yeah, so I built that one when I was 10, 12 with a mechano motor, just with him for fun. It was very nice. And I think, yeah, that's when I started to learn about electricity, let's say, about different types of currents and how to use them. So I think that in some sense, it was because of him that at the end I was more interested on doing. I'm doing electronic devices in the nanoscale, and physics used to describe them are in the quantum. I think what's funny that I do here is that he works in a printed circuits industry. There's a lot of people doing a very specified part of the process to, at the end, deliver these, PCBs, printed circuit boards, that are nowadays in the computers. What I do here is that I am the whole industry, let's say. We design, then we go to the lab and we fabricate it, we test that everything is going in a way or in another. If it goes great, then we go to measurement. It's about all this process that nowadays in industry, they are all so divided in categories and different people very well-formed and specialized on these different parts that at the end make a whole. But here in research, you do all. You go from nothing to have a device in your hands, which is nice.